Hello everyone, in this lecture we are starting with the LR parsing. We have already seen the shift reduce parsing technique. In case you are watching this lecture, you should first watch the shift reduce parsing technique lecture that I have recorded earlier. And in the shift reduce parsing, if we have a string and we want to check if the string given is according to the grammar rules, then what we do that for some of the symbols of the string, we push on the stack, and after looking at if any of the production has the right hand side and that appears on the stack, we reduce that right hand side to the left hand side of the production. Now the shift reduce parsing technique has a problem that when we have to do the shift, means push on the stack, or reduce, it means take some of the top symbols of the stack and reduce that by the left hand side of the production. We're not aware about, or we are not able to decide when should we actually push on the stack and when should actually we reduce the symbols by the left hand side of the production. So LR parsers are there to help us, and the LR parsers are actually helping us to do the bottom up parsing. There are four types of the LR parsers. One is the LR0 parsing, SLR1 parsing, then LALR parsing, and LALR, and then CLR1 parsing. Now, what happens in the LR0 and SLR1, we compute the canonical collection of LR0 items. And for these two, means the LALR1 and CLR1 parsers, we compute the canonical collection of LR1 items. Right? So we are computing the canonical collection of LR0 items in for the LR0 and SLR1 parsing, and we are computing the LR1 items for LALR1 parsing and CLR1 parsing. Now, what these canonical collection of LR0 and LR1 items are, we will see that with the progress of the lecture. And suppose we have a grammar production rule, S produces AA. Then if we are applying the dot, meaning that, and the right hand side, I have not seen any symbol. And if we apply a dot here, it means that I have seen one A, and then one A is already pending. And if we apply a dot at the end of the production on the right hand side, we can say that we have seen both the A's on the right hand side, and now we can reduce the AA symbol to the left hand side of the production, that is capital S. Okay, so we have to find the, if we have to find the LR0 items, or we have to do the LR0 parsing, then for that we need to apply these kind of technique by which the dots are shifted and accordingly the new items are produced. Okay, we are not considering any look ahead here, so that's why under bracket 0, that means we are not taking any look aheads here. Suppose we have a grammar given, that grammar is S produces AA, A produces small a capital A, and another production capital A produces small b. And if we have to do the LR parsing here, we from our side add another production, S dash produces S, that produces the start symbol. So the grammar given to us is this one, S produces AA, A produces small a capital A, capital A produces B. From our side, we are considering that we have one more production, that is S dash produces S. Now the collection of all these four is called the augmented grammar. So now this is the augmented grammar. If we add a new production from our side, we will consider that this is the augmented grammar. Fine. So in the augmented grammar, if I am applying the dot here at the beginning, that means we have not seen anything. And now we are going to compute the closure of this. Okay, we are going to compute the closure of this. So S dash produces dot capital S. So what is there in the closure? After dot, a non-terminal is appearing. So what we do, we should write all the production starting with capital S with a dot in the beginning. So S produces dot capital A, capital A. Now here, after the dot, a capital A is appearing. So we will write all the production starting with capital A with a dot in the beginning. So one of the production is this, that starts with capital A, and then another one is this one. Fine. So by this way, we have computed the closure of this. Fine. Let us consider that this closure is item number 0. Okay, or the state number 0. More like that what we have, we used to take in the DFAs or NFA. We were giving some number to the states. Similarly, this also has been given a number, that is 0. Now what we do, out of these items, we shift the dot one by one. So we are shifting the dot here for this production, and this actually becomes, we are taking a capital S and shifting the dot, means we have seen capital S, so the dot shifts. Dot has been shifted to this space and a new state has got produced. Let's say the number of this, we have given a number to this state, that is 1. Now, after having seen the capital S, let's see a capital A. So if you see the capital A here, the production changes to S produces A dot A. It means we have seen 1A and 1A is still pending. Okay. Now after the dot, we have a capital A. It means we are finding the closure of this. So all the productions starting with capital A with a dot in the beginning. Fine. Now we have another one, dot B. No more productions would be added here. So this is the new state we have produced. Let's say the number given to this state is 2. Fine. So now here we will now see small a. So if we take the small a here, A produces small a dot capital A. Then since we are computing the closure also, so after the dot the capital A appears. So all the productions starting with capital A with a dot in the beginning. Fine. So we have taken a small a and we have reached to the new state. Let's say the number of the new state is 3. So here we have seen capital S, capital A, small a. Now we see the capital B here. Sorry, small b here. So by seeing this small b, you just see that a dot is shifted after the b. We have seen small b. And let's say this is the new state. Let us give it a number 4. Okay. Now we should start looking at the next symbol here also. So the dot is at the last position. So no possibility of looking at more symbols here. Now here, the dot is here somewhere in between. So we can take a capital A here. So S produces capital A, capital A, and a dot. And let's say this is the new state. The number of this state is 5. Now here, if you take the small a, fine. Let's take a small a here. What we are going to see here. If we take the small a, it will be A produces A dot capital A, and since we had computing the closure, so after the dot there is a capital A, so all the production is starting with capital A with a dot at the beginning. So you see all these productions are there in this state. So if you take a small a, you will go to this state. Fine. So if you take a small a, you will go to this state. Now if you take small b, what will happen if you take this small b? So by taking this small b, you will reach to this state. The dot b dot will be shifted after the b. So if you take a small b, you will reach to this state. Fine. So after taking the small b, you are shifting to this state. So all the dot, all the dots have been shifted here. All the symbols have been taken here. Now, let's see about this one. If you take a capital A here, you're actually reaching to the new state. So you've seen the capital A, and you're reaching to the new state, that is A produces small a, capital A, and a dot. Fine. Now, if you take small a here, you will once again see this one. A small a, dot will be shifted after small a. So this one, we are computing the closure. So all the production is starting with capital A with a dot in the beginning. This one and this one. Okay. So if you take a small a, you will remain with this state only. Okay. Now if you take a small b, you will reach to this state. A b has been taken, a dot will be shifted after that. This is the new state, let's say we are giving it a number 6. Okay. So this is how we compute the canonical collection of LR0 items. Fine. So we have computed the canonical collection of LR0 items here. Now, having computed this LR0 items, let us make the parsing table. Okay. So for making the parsing table, what we actually need, we need to make a table in which on the row side, we will write the state numbers. So what you see here in this canonical collection of LR0 items, that you have the state from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 is the last state. So let's make a table and on the row, in the row side, write the state numbers. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. On the column side, you have to write the non-terminals and terminals both. So first write the terminal symbols. What are the terminal symbols here? We have a terminal symbol is small a, we have a terminal symbol is small b, and then we have a dollar, which is a special non-terminal symbol, which tells us the end of the string. Fine. So this is the terminal symbols that we have written. Now we will write the non-terminal symbol. Those are s and capital A. So here we are not writing the S dash, because S dash was our assumed symbol. S dash is not the symbol which is given the grammar, so that we have actually assumed. So now we have to make this table. We have made a separate part for the terminal symbol and a separate part for the non-terminal symbol. For this part, we will say that what action we are taking. So we are writing action here, and here we will write go to, where we will go actually. Okay, now we will see this canonical collection of items, and then we will be filling the entries in this table. So this is the zero, this is the zero state. Fine. From zero state, on looking at one, looking at S, capital S symbol, we are going to state number one. So in the table, in the zero row, capital S, we will write 1. Similarly, from 0 state, looking at symbol A, we are going to state number 2. So on 0 state, looking at symbol A, we are going to 2 state. And then on 0 state, looking at small a symbol, we are going to state number 3. So obviously, in the 0 with symbol A, we are going to 3. So we'll write 3, but along with this, for every non-terminal every terminal symbol, we will write S also along with the number, state number. So this actually tells us that we are going to shift this symbol on the stack. So we are shifting the A symbol on the, we will shift this A symbol on the stack whenever the, we will be doing the parsing, and the rule number is 3. Okay. Now similarly, on looking at B from 0 state, we are going to state number 4. So from 0, small b, we are going to 4 number state, but we will write the shift also along with this. Fine. Now you see just this one. We are actually ignoring this one part. the state number one. We will look at this later. So from the state number two, with a capital S symbol, you're going to 5. State number two, capital S symbol, you're just going to state number 5. State number two, with a small a, you're going to 3. So with a small a symbol, you're going to 3. That means you'll write S3 here. 2, small b, you're going to 4. So 2, small b, you will write S4. Fine, 2 is complete. We're going to 3 now. In 3, with capital A, you're going to 6 state. In 3, with capital A, you're going to 6. In 3, with a small a symbol, you're remaining with the same state, that is 3. So in 3, with a small a, we're going to remain in the same state, that is the S3. With the small b, you are going to state number 4. Okay, so with the 4, with 3, with small b, you are going to state number 4. Now you see, with the state number 4, there is no transition. With the state number 5, there is no transition. With the state number 6, there is no transition. Now come at this one. Now suppose we were shifting some of the symbols on the stack, and then we are observing that on the stack the start symbol has appeared. That means we have actually reduced all the symbols in the string to the start state. So if we have already done that, there is no reason that we should progress the parsing further. It means our parsing is complete. So once we have seen a dot after the capital S, it means we have converted the entire string symbols to the start symbol. No need to go further. It means the string has been accepted. So on one with dollar, state number is 1, where the dot is appearing after the S. So in one, at the place of the dollar, you're going to write accept. Okay, now if we have to see, this table is not complete even now. So what you're going to do, you just say, see in which of the production the dot is appearing at the last. Okay, so dot is appearing in the last here in the state number 5, in a state number 6, and a state number 4 also. Obviously in the state number 1, but we have already seen that what action we have to do here. The dot is appearing after the capital S, so we are writing 1 in the place of the dollar except. Okay, now what we are going to do for this 5 state, 6 state and the 4 state where the dot is appearing as the last symbol. Okay, now come to this production rules. So in these production rules which were given to us, let us number these productions. Let's number this as 1, number this as 2, and number this as 3rd production. Okay, so this is the 3rd production, this is the 2nd production, and this is the 1st production. So what we're going to do, if you have seen a dot at the last position here, in let's say in the 5 state, it means that we have seen all the symbol on the right hand side. Now it's now the turn for converting the right hand side symbols to the left hand side symbol. So we are going to reduce this part with the left hand side of the symbol. So in the state number 5, let's go to the state number 5 here in the table. On every terminal symbols, at the place of every terminal symbol, we are going to reduce. So what we are going to reduce, but reduce by what rule? This S produces AA is first production. Okay, so we will write R1, means we are going to reduce, but with the production number 1. So in at the 5 in the table, in the 5th row in the table, in every place of the terminal symbol, we are going to write R1. Okay, now look at the 6th state. So this A produces small a, capital A is the 2nd production here. So in the 6th row, we are going to write R2. R2 means we are going to reduce with the production number 2nd. Now see this 4th state, A produces B dot. This actually is the 3rd production symbol, 3rd production. So we will write in the 4th row, at all the terminal symbols place, we are going to write R3, production rule 3. Fine. So this is how we compute the parsing table, the LR0 parsing table. So we are done with the LR0 parsing table. In the next lecture, we will see how we can parse the given string. Thank you.